everyone, I am Srikarthik. I am glad to address you, the honorable members of the parliament of one of the biggest and successful democracies in the world, India. I am here to present the views of the World Bank on the Indus Water Treaty. I am proud to say this treaty is one of the most successful treaties in the world history. It has empowered both India and Pakistan to share water peacefully for the past 56 years. From talks with Indian leaders and officials, World Bank understands that India has a few concerns about the provisions of the treaty. The percentage of water allocated to Jammu and Kashmir is only 20%, and the left bank outfall drain constructed by Pakistan, which passes through the Ranakkach area, Gujarat, India, runs the risk of flood situation often. Similarly, Pakistan has expressed its concern over the two hydroelectric projects, Kishan Ganga and Rattle, built by India in Jammu and Kashmir. World Bank is confident that these concerns can be addressed peacefully and the treaty can be upheld successfully. Let us all remember that any treaty is to benefit mankind. The waters which form the basis of any human settlement should be a unifying factor and not a bone of contention. Any attempt to stop or alter the water supply will affect the common people first. Farmers dependent on irrigation and people drawing potable water from the rivers will be the first and most affected people even before the country, government or economy comes into picture. Causing adverse effect on people's food and water will be nothing short than declaring a direct war on them. The world believes that India, the peaceful nation which has never invaded any nation in its history, will not consider this inhuman step. We appreciate the fact that India has always stuck to its side of the treaty and provided water to Pakistan even during the declared wars. India's foremost problem has been terrorism, but it is common knowledge that poverty and lack of development is the root cause of all ills in the society. Any disruptions in basic livelihood, either from nature or from government, will make common man suffer, become helpless and turn towards undesirable activities. The current decision of Indian government to suspend talks on permanent Indus Commission is a great setback. The commission should be allowed to continue. The World Bank is hoping that the permanent Indus Commission and bilateral talks can resolve these issues amicably. Let us all give the dialogue another chance and let peace prevail and nurture humanity. Thank you.